Theatre today. Before I start, I'm going to give two postcards and pass them around. In one postcard, there's a small child. In the other postcard, the same child, but in a different pose, a different style. Please tell me who it is, if you can. Please pass them around. Can I? So I've got this wire on my head. Can you pass on? It's the same child. See if you can tell who it is. You can see the postcard's quite old. It's about 100 years old now. I think it's from the, or maybe slightly less, maybe from the early Taisho period. Nobody? Okay. Okay, I'll come back to that just so you can pass it around and have a look at it. I'm here today just because I'm lucky. I am lucky enough to have worked in several types of Japanese theatre. I'm not an actor. I never will be. I don't want to be an actor. But I'm lucky enough to have worked connected to several types of Japanese theatre. And I've worked with Kabuki and Shochoku and the National No Theatre. And most recently with Takarazuka. And I'm the only foreign person connected to Takarazuka. There's not many people in there at all. The only reason I do it is because I lied. Some people say you should never lie. I disagree. I like theatre. I've liked theatre since I was a child. I think I first saw theatre aged about 10 or 11, live theatre. And it was Shakespeare in England. And it was boring. Because I was 10 or 11 years old. Shakespeare's boring to any 10 or 11 year old boy. But I saw theatre, and I've always liked live performances more than TV or movies. I came to Japan in 1997, as you heard. I worked in Kabuki, I worked in No. I never worked in Takarazuka, and I wanted to just see a show, just to see what it's like, to see why people say the fans are so strange, and I just wanted to see a show, and I couldn't get tickets. And tickets were so hard to get. The fans have special ways to get the tickets, and there's no open tickets. It's not easy to get. So I lied. Because I work as a writer for some newspapers and magazines, I contacted the people at the Takarazuka Theatre and said, I will do an article. When you say that, they love publicity. Free tickets. And that's the way that writers get into theatres, for nothing. They just offer articles. But Takarazuka is like Kabuki. It's like No. There's many points of Japanese theatre that I could talk about today, and you would probably sleep. Because many points of Japanese theatre in history are very, very boring. But some points are quite interesting, including the points I've put on the board. First, at the very top, theatre. What is the difference? Spelling, yeah. Yeah, of course, I mean, that's the American spelling, and this is the correct spelling. So I'm English, so this is mine. But there is a difference in Japan. What is the difference? Does anyone know? Go to the Kabuki Theatre. We'll look at the homepage in English. Oh, okay, thank you. Look at any movie theatre. Look at any... thank you. Any theatre where they perform live. And this is always used in Japanese as the movie theatre. This is used by the people who perform live in Japan. There's no right or wrong with the spelling. But it's just something I've noticed over many years. The National No Theatre use this one because it's live. Why? I don't know. I've asked them. They don't know. But they do. Movies always use that one. Is anybody here connected to No or Shochoku? Or we have some women. No Takarazuka actresses secretly here. No? Some of them do speak English, actually. I will give you some interesting points, and I hope, building on the information that you know as Japanese people, you know basics about all of them. You may be very aware of some of them. But these points you may not know. K, Kabuki. N, No. And T, Takarazuka. He's quite famous too. Kabuki bathwater. It's strange, isn't it? A few years ago, here in Japan, 17 years ago, you had the problem with Orm. And that guy was caught yesterday, Takahashi somebody. and he was caught. When their leader was powerful, his fans used to drink his bathwater, which is strange. But the same used to happen in Kabuki. Fans used to drink the bathwater of some of the actors. So Asahara is not so strange. He was copying Danjiro. Danjiro used to sell his bathwater to the fans, who would then drink it. Kim Jong-il, connection to Kabuki. Does anybody know the connection? No? Please look on page 82 here. There's one. These are all the actors in Kabuki. One of the actors, his nickname is Kim, in Shochiku. Can you see which one looks like Kim Jong-il? Yeah. And his nickname is Kim. Inside the Shochiku. Can you see which one? There may be a second book here. Page 82. Let me give this one this way. Okay, page 73. Same guy. Can you see which one looks like Kim? Yeah. That's why his nickname is Kim. Can you see? Yeah. Kind of similar, isn't it? Just a few minor points to start. There's a guy there, you'll see, nicknamed Kim. No. In the theatre of No, I've worked with... I've only actually worked with the Kanze group of No and performances they've put on in Japan and overseas, in Germany and India. They tell me they never, ever rehearse a play together. The individual actor will rehearse his part, but they will never rehearse as a group. So the first time you see it, and it's only usually for one day when you see a no play, they don't perform like Kabuki and Takarazuka every day. They perform together for the very first time, having rehearsed individually. Also in the dressing rooms, in the changing rooms, backstage, the person who sits nearest the door to go to the stage is the junior. The senior actors always sit furthest away from the door, from the stage. Just minor points, but we'll come back to some of them later. And in Takarazuka, men are okay. There's a famous belief about the school of Takarazuka down in Hyogo that no man is allowed to enter. It's fake. One type of man is allowed to enter. Does anybody know what kind of guy can enter? Military people. Men from the Japanese Self-Defense Force are allowed to enter to teach them marching. Because if you've ever seen Takarazuka, some places have lots of military parts where they march, they salute, and they are taught how to do that by male members of the Self-Defense Force. And silent singing. Has anybody here ever been to a dress rehearsal of Takarazuka? Not to the live show, but to the dress rehearsal. The dress rehearsal in Tokyo, in Hibiya, is carried out the same day as the performance starts, in the morning, from about 10 o'clock. Sometimes they don't actually sing. They try to save their voice. So the music's playing, they go through the gestures, the lips are moving, but nothing comes out. And it's quite strange, first time. You think something's broken, or her microphone is broken or something. All parts of Japanese theatre, and there's many other types of Japanese theatre, contemporary theatre, but we don't have time to go over those today. And just one thing from Japanese contemporary theatre, more Japanese Shakespeare actors are alive today than any other nationality. There are more Shakespeare groups in Japan today than in the UK. Than in any other country on earth. The Japanese love Shakespeare. Some of the actors are fantastic and some are awful. But that's theatre. You have your own opinions. I won't stand here and tell you today what theatre is, because I don't think that's correct. I think you would go yourself and have an opinion. You could sit next to me You could love the play. I dislike it. I could love it. You hate it. Theatre's theatre. Theatre's what you make of it. Please let me ask you just quickly, a few people, how old were you when you first watched a live theatre performance in Japan?